Okay, kids, everybody sit down and grab a comfortable spot. We're gonna have a little story. Not your normal story. It's gonna have all your favorite characters from all your favorite books. And it's gonna be written and told by Figgkid, your favorite storyteller. So get ready. Don't be scared. All these characters are doing normal things. You'll find this out when you grow older. But for now, we're gonna sum it up in one big song. So here I go, the Figgkid story called Fairytale.
I continue with stories that Figgkid is ever so slightly disfunctorous, so listen to clever interpolations of fictionist tales and stories of good and bad in confrontation. I go off the track of the regular fables and integrate people that sign with the label. Quite entertaining, so listen intently, FIGGKIDD, with what I'm presenting.
One very fine day in the castle of Queen, whose daughter was not very interesting, and fitted a slipper of glass is a thing.
The bitch was a hooker and into swinging. Anyway, she was in for with the prince, was a knight on the side and pretty intense. Dude had a baby to one of her friends, Rapunzel the slut, but that's not
I'm
the
talking
end.
The same shit until you say God. It sounded like blah 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 blah.
The Fairytale Master writing them faster than anyone.
Kids will think it's great and parents will too, cause they relate to what I say.
Down in the woods today, cause that's where dangerous bears will lay. They don't eat pottery, they eat people. Don't take their grand stories, feed you. Sleep in their bed, they'll take off your head, tear off your limbs and then leave you for dead. Now scare you off like Goldilocks. I'm serious when I tell you to not play with bears.
Now Rapunzel was fucking this knight in two ways, taking his money then leaving for days, betting on horses, losing the cash and coming back quick and kissing his ass. The horses were ridden by several men who had a chick who was cooking for them,
called Snow White because of her habit, snorting the coke with Peter the Rabbit.
It's funny how everything ends in this story, Little Red Riding Hood taking the glory. Sorry to break the news to the people, the books that had never mentioned the sequel. Wolf survived the slice to the stomach and ended up killing the Little Red Riding Hood. The truth has never been harder. The children have grown. The picture is all about bad luck. Who really gives a fuck? It sounded like blah 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 blah.
The Fairytale Master writing them faster than anyone.
Kids will think it's great and parents will too, cause they relate to what I say.
Don't go down in the woods today, cause that's where dangerous bears will lay. They don't eat pottery, they eat people. Don't think they're grabbing stories, feed you. Sleep in their bed, they'll take off your head, tear off your limbs and then leave you for dead. Now scare you off like Goldilocks. I'm serious when I tell you to not play with bears. So we'll go, the final chapter. Kitties are scared and parents are laughing. With all the shit talking going on, I've lost the plot of the story and so on and so on. Sorry to start and you waiting in angst. I guess in a way now this track is a prank. I never knew that I could tell a good yarn and have you all sitting inside of my palm. The moral I'm thinking is really quite basic. Don't listen to people that's wearing a tracer. They're usually running away from the cops. So my story is come compliment of my stop to take some innocent people as hostage. Don't move a muscle because I get blasted. Thank you for from my tales to land happily ever after the end.
Come here with your hands up.
Don't fucking push me, cat. I got these kids.
Mummy wouldn't like that.